Introduction to NYTD, Part 2. Data collection and reporting. United, together we can spread the word. States are required to assess their performance in delivering services to assist youth in making a transition from foster care. But how do they do this? First, states collect information on youth and the independent living services they receive that are paid for or provided by the state. Second, states collect outcome information on all youth in foster care at age 17, whom the state will survey again at ages 19 and 21. By outcomes, we mean the experiences youth report as they transition to adulthood, including their experiences with the state's independent living program and services. States are then required to provide data reports on these services and outcomes to the Children's Bureau every 6 months. States collect data on three groups of youth. These categories are the served population, the baseline population, and the follow-up population. The served population refers to all youth who receive at least one independent living service paid for or provided by the state agency in the reporting period. The served population includes tribal youth, juvenile justice youth, and current and former foster youth. The baseline population refers to all youth who are in foster care and reach their 17th birthday during the current federal fiscal year in which a survey is conducted. States collect data on a new baseline population every 3 years. What's the federal fiscal year, you ask? The federal fiscal year runs from October 1st through September 30th. Lastly, the follow-up population refers to the youth who reach their 19th and 21st birthdays after taking the baseline survey at age 17. Now, it's possible that a youth may be in more than one reporting population. For example, a 21-year-old youth may participate in the NYTD survey. She may also be receiving assistance from the state to complete college. As a result, she would be in both the follow-up population and the served population. Let's review what types of information states are required to collect. States collect three different types of information for NYTD: demographics of the youth receiving services, services they are provided, and outcomes they achieve. By demographics, we mean general information about the youth, like their date of birth, race and ethnicity, sex, tribal membership, foster care status, and education level. By services, we mean those services provided by the state to the youth in transition, like academic support, career preparation, budgeting, mentoring, health education, and financial assistance. And finally, NYTD collects information on the outcome experiences reported by young people in five areas: financial self-sufficiency, educational attainment, experiences with homelessness, high-risk behaviors, and access to health insurance. The Children's Bureau tracks which independent living services states provide and the outcomes youth experience during their transition to adulthood. This helps determine the effectiveness of independent living services nationwide. By helping measure program performance, NYTD data can be used by states to tailor services to better meet the needs of young people. United Rap, written by foster care alumni Kim Rose and Janae Swain, along with help from the state of California, California Department of Social Services, CDSS. Performed by Janae and Kim, The West Coast Flow. For more information, visit https://www.fosterclub.com/article/u-nytd-rap. This video was developed in partnership with the Administration for Children and Families, the Children's Bureau, an office of the Administration for Children and Families, and the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services. The end.